Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. For nearly half a century, the chief principals of the Thunderbolts Project have been presenting a scientific case for relatively recent celestial catastrophes in the inner solar system, within human memory. These events were recorded in the myths and storytelling of ancient man in prehistory, the dramas reverberating through generations and shaping the earliest civilizations. The catastrophes were electromagnetic in nature, planets seen in the earthly sky discharging electrically, the thunderbolts of the gods. But what about more recent disasters in the AD time periods? Disasters that also may have been triggered by fundamentally electromagnetic phenomena in the solar system. In recent episodes, Thunderbolt's colleague Peter Mungo Jupp has explored the voluminous evidence for the electrical nature of comets. As Jupp has noted, it is an unlikely coincidence that mankind viewed comets for millennia as harbingers of doom and destruction. In modern times, we witness the spectacular influence of a comet on a planet in Shoemaker-Levy-9's close encounter with Jupiter. In this episode, Jupp offers the provocative conjecture that such an encounter between our own planet and a cometary intruder may have caused an AD disaster that caused the death of tens of millions of human beings, the so-called Plague of Justinian.
Thomas Short, writing in the 18th century, chronicled the many calamities that had decimated mankind over the last 4,000 years. Earthquakes, plagues, pestilence, incredibly overwhelming floods. But as you read through this curious book, you are intrigued by the number of comets associated with these dramas, unmatched in modern history.
In the early century of the prison era, the Romans at one time counted 50 comets in their skies. This is unheard of today. Were the skies over Rome the end of a bloody era that only in recent centuries has become stabilised? Can there be bones of truth in this mythology?
They are invariably connected to the major disasters, and up until the 1800s, mankind held a fear of comets. What happened? Then the Age of Reason struck, and incredibly, the number of highly visible comets shrunk. Had something happened? Eventually, by the end of the 20th century, it became scientific dogma that comets were dusty snowballs. How incredibly wrong this early scientific theory has been proven by modern science and its observation of comets.
So we've seen the dramatic effects comets can have on at least Jupiter and the Sun. But what about the planets, and particularly Earth? Have comets in the past had dramatic effects on Earth? And this is where we come to plague, war, flood, earthquakes, pestilence, and famine. Has in fact the cosmos, in the form of comets, the Sun, planets in disturbed motion, or the outer reaches of the universe, affected Earth and caused chaos? Has in fact this occurred on the Earth? Have comets caused the demise of civilizations? Claude Schaeffer documented at least six destructions of civilizations prior to the Christian era, spanning at least 2,000 years.
But did later lower scale calamities also affect civilizations? I suspect yes. So now let's go to the first of these more recent deadly events. 1,500 years ago, a pungent plague nearly exterminated mankind.
The Emperor Justinian from Constantinople
gave his name to this empire wrecker.
Thomas Short wrote, from 560 AD, a plague raged for 52 years, the like of which has never been seen before. Conventional wisdom maintains this worldwide plague began in Ethiopia and was carried by ship-borne rats to Europe and beyond. However, don't forget, with our new knowledge of bacteria and viruses being carried by vectors far above the Earth, this theory of deployment has been questioned. Our pertinent scrutiny asks not only what caused this exterminating plague with its incredible and unmatched virulence, but whether some parallel catastrophic events had a similar foundational driver.
It was totally chaotic in nature. It struck in many different seasons, with its virulence and invasiveness changed from city to city. And amongst every age group and gender, it was ruthlessly indiscriminate. And even if you survived, no immunity was guaranteed upon the next episode.
Death was usually within 3 days from multiple causes. Buboes and high fever, carbuncles and suicidal madness, but quick and immediate death. The mortality rate was horrific when compared to modern experiences of plague or any other pathology. Short says, for instance, that in ancient Constantinople, that's Istanbul, 10,000 people died a day when the plague struck. Placing this dreadful scourge aside and examining parallel events, we find some remarkable coincidences. During this plague period, no less than 9 highly visible comets were seen. Weird blood-coloured flashing skies and strangely multiple suns often accompanied this scenario. Also associated were 10 incredibly destructive earthquake storms. For instance, Antioch, 200,000 dead, and 7 worldwide mega famines. Accompanying this were totally chaotic and unseasonal weather with cataclysmic inundations by water, wind, and tempers. Now, at this stage, I emphasize these famines and other dramas were not normal occurrences. For instance, on several occasions, Short notes the famines were so devastating that women horrifically ate or sold their own children to survive. In the widespread earthquakes, whole towns were swallowed up and lakes formed and cities burned. Was this perhaps from methane seepage or massive lightning storms, plasmoids? Are these parallel events associated? The possibility of an electro-universe connection should be considered. For instance, what drives the virulence of bacteria? Stimulation of growth and degradation by ions, neutrons, electrons, and the spectrum of electromagnetic radiation are claimed from various sources. Thus, what place do not only solar events have to play in bacterial invasiveness, but possibly of mankind's classically dreaded comet? Comets, although they travel fairly well-defined elliptical orbits, are virtually undecoded phenomena. Some pass by the sun harmlessly, some disintegrate and break into many sections, such as Shoemaker-Levy 9, when it collided with Jupiter. Others graze by the sun with little known effect, whilst occasionally some bury themselves in the sun and appear to translate to coronal mass ejections on the opposite side. The factors governing this seemingly but probably not chaotic behaviour is a mystery. However, we have come to understand they are negatively charged, somewhat like a mobile Z-pinch. They must therefore interrelate to other electrets. But the methodology of this behaviour is merely speculation, and certainly as Short's novels show anecdotal evidence and suggest just this inferred behaviour. Of these 9 spectacular comets that occurred during the Justinian plague. Now, equally, we're satisfied that earthquakes are shaped in some way by electrical phenomena.
It's always been a puzzle to geologists where the energy of an earthquake comes from. The energy comes from the stored electric charge within the Earth. A discharge takes place beneath the Earth, then you must get effects on the surface that are felt. And the earthquake is one such consequence.
Right, so it's just like thunder and lightning, but it's beneath
it's underground, the Earth. Yes.
Finally, weather is more and more being seen as an electrical phenomena, certainly by EU advocates. In addition, chaos theory maintains that outside attractors establish a new harmonic. These constantly adjusting, perhaps radically adjusting, electromagnetic influences are the central cause of heavily chaotic, unseasonal and extreme weather such as floods. This in turn causes dramatic famine and drought. From all these possibly related events, short quotes, two-thirds of all people died. This is a summary from one of his primary sources, the Chronicle Magdeburg. This Justinian plague was preceded often by the appearance of several suns at the same time. Other times the sun was quite darkened. A comet appeared a whole year together, darting forth its beams like swords. The heavens seemed all of a flame and several other meteors fell. Nowadays, we automatically dismiss this evidence from a bygone era as fanciful, exaggerated, and primitive. But there's bigger questions here. Could these cosmic dramas that influence weather also be driving plagues, locust inundations, earthquakes, and the very wars of mankind? And the big unanswered question, comets. Historically always feared in man's history and legends. If a comet can hit Jupiter, Shoemaker-Levy 9, or a comet can cause the sun to have a massive CME, could not they too be involved in this cosmic drama that affects weather, plague, and earthquakes? Unanswered questions needing more investigation.